We want to keep you updated on what's going on in Israel-Palestine. It has gotten even worse, as predicted, but man, it really hope that we could avoid some of this. The death toll in Gaza has risen to 48 Palestinians, including 14 children and 3 women, according to their health ministry. More than 300 people have been wounded, including 86 children and 39 women. And wounded can mean some really bad stuff. That's so many children in those two categories. Now, additionally, 6 Israelis, including a soldier, 3 women and a child were killed, and dozens of people were wounded. So the violence has continued incredibly disproportionately, surprising literally no one. But additionally, the form of the violence, the sorts of buildings that have been targeted, has thankfully generated a lot of international discussion about these tactics. Not new tactics, by the way. In past sets of airstrikes in Gaza, we've seen things like this. But I want to talk about one particular instance. This is a high-rise apartment building in a densely populated Gaza City that was destroyed intentionally. It was specifically targeted, and I believe we have some footage of it actually happening. So that was, I'm reading, the tallest structure in that city. The people in it were warned to get out, and it was destroyed. Why? It was the tallest structure in the city. And it really sends a signal. It really sends a message to the people there that you can destroy it and probably get away without any consequences whatsoever. The structure, by the way, housed residential apartments, medical production companies, and a dental clinic. There's no immediate word of casualties. Within 15 minutes of its destruction, the armed resistance wing of Islamic Jihad announced it would retaliate with rockets aimed at Tel Aviv. Hamas said it fired more than 130 into Israel after the attack. Indiscriminate rocket attacks against civilian areas are also considered war crimes under international law. And more discriminate, or indiscriminate, I should say. We don't know who might have been injured or killed as a result of that. But we do know a little bit about the view inside of some of the power structures in Israel of the destroying of that particular building. This is a meme that was posted by IDF Online, and the translation is before and after. So a lot of people suffering in the area, a lot of people just devastated by what they're seeing internationally, but some people are having fun with it, JR. Some people enjoy what's happening.
It's always going to be that way. So obviously, these types of conflicts are as old as anyone can remember, right? And we get new versions of them however many years or months in between each of them. But to this level, apparently has been this big, or this potentially is where it could go since, like, you know, since what, 2014, I believe they said. But it's hard because we know the same thing is going to be said over and over and over again. And many folks on, no matter which part of this, knows that, especially us over here, aren't looking at this and seeing exactly what's happening and how it's happening, when it's happening, what triggered it, and which folks got shoved out this time, and then what their circumstance was, and then what their immediate response was. And if these rockets coming over from Gaza then were in response to, and in what way and what targets they hit. But the one thing we always do know after all of this is happening and these devastating attacks on both sides, there's one side that is devastatingly way more power and weaponry than another. And that's just one of those things that needs to be pointed out. So when people are getting killed, and we always see the casualties and injuries are way larger on one side, you don't have to wonder why. You don't have to excuse the fact that children are being murdered, or even try to insinuate that those are inaccurate accounts, which of course are, whose spokesperson was that said that yesterday, decided to try to deny the fact that children are being killed here, because that would look bad. This is all looking like a bad PR thing right now. And that's what they're concerned about, more than they're concerned about people being killed and what they're being killed over, and potentially how you can stop it. The only thing that's ever said is, oh, well, you know what they're doing? They got civilians, and they got rockets, and they got military equipment inside these buildings. So you bomb the whole thing, and then we're supposed to just say that's okay.
Yep.
And then also, yeah, believe, and it, by the way, you know.
Yeah, I don't even know if in this particular case that was asserted, whether it was true or not. I don't even believe that they were asserting that about the building. They're just destroying buildings. It's not new, but they're doing it. And sometimes you're right. What's that?
One spokesman from the Israeli side went on MSNBC and had a discussion about it, and he claimed the same thing. Thing is, I predicted he was going to say that. That's how much it's said in the previous. I was like, well, they're going to say that there's some machinery inside of these buildings. We had to take it down, and they're hiding behind women and children. So if they're hiding behind women and children, do you shoot the women and children in the face? Is that the policy? Is that the policy that America agrees with? I mean, maybe it is.
As of right
maybe
now.
Maybe it is.
And well, we're going to turn to that, actually. but also, and there's a great thread in this. I apologize that I don't remember the name of the, it's a lawyer who does work in war crimes. They make these vague assertions of Hamas or other groups using human shields. That is actually a very specific thing that they're asserting. When you take hostages, you put them near their forces so that they can't be targeted. The fighters being in an urban area is not taking human shields. That's not what that is at all. When you cram people in a very small area, thus necessitating that if there is violence, it will be near civilians, that does not mean that you can just bomb whatever you want. That's actually not at all what that means.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.